And welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to be doing my first ever mod overview or review. This is something actually I want to start on my channel because I really like watching them and I really like using mods and stuff in my game, so it'd be quite nice to like review them and show them to you guys to see if you'd like them. And the first one I'm going to be overviewing for this little series is the Autumn mod, which was made by Danny Paradise, and the link will be down below to download it, of course. And I absolutely love this mod. When I first saw this on come up on my Tumblr dashboard, I cried a little bit because I was like, no, this can't be real. Like, how can someone make it look like it's autumn inside of the game when we don't have seasons? And someone has been able to do it and it looks absolutely amazing. And I can see this is what seasons is going to look like when we finally do get that expansion pack, whenever that may be. But it looks so real, it looks like something EA made, and it just looks amazing. And I'm sure if you have a better quality PC than what I have, because mine isn't the best, it will look even better. So in this, I'm just going to be showing you the three different worlds, Willow Creek, Oasis Springs, and Newcrest. It does also work in the world which comes with Outdoor Retreat. I can't remember what it's called, but I don't have Outdoor Retreat, so I can't show you that. Just a bit about this mod. This mod comes with 340 overrides, which means the 340 things have been overrided to look autumnal or fall-like. There are some trees and bits of grass which have been missed. You can see the grass on these rocks. That hasn't been changed because obviously I don't think you can change that. But all of the trees and the majority of the plants have changed. And obviously the watercolour, like of the rivers, hasn't changed. That's still the vibrant blue. So there are 7 different files to download. Six of those are, you know, you need them, and the 7th one you don't need if you don't want it. The 7th one changes the colour of the grass, and I'll show you the grass in a second. But the rest of them you need for this full mod to work. And don't worry, the files aren't actually that big, even though it has 340 overrides. Because like I said, I do not have the most powerful PC, and this really hasn't affected any gameplay, I don't think. In my game, and I have probably one of the lowest spec PCs out of gamers on YouTube, so yeah. So that's basically most of the information I have off Danny Paradise's website, which again I will link below. And now I am just going to show you some of the worlds. So at the minute I am in Willow Creek, just on my tester save file. I'm just going to zoom all the way out. You can see my little tester area down there, so you can see what it looks like. I think that this mod has added kind of like a hazy effect onto the game. It doesn't, obviously isn't as vibrant because, you know, the trees are different and everything, but it has changed some parts of it. And I just love how the orange colours of these trees and even things down to these little shrubs have changed. And this is what I meant about the water, a very vibrant blue, and the green on the rocks hasn't changed. But yeah, so I'm just going to show you the grass, which I was talking about. So let's just zoom in down here. As you can see, here is the grass. Now it's been changed to this kind of like, not dead, but kind of like worn out kind of colour. You know, the kind of colour grass goes in the autumn time, because obviously it's dying back compared to what it's like in the summer. So it's changed and it looks really nice, actually. But yeah, this is what this part of Willow Creek looks like. I'm not going to go all over Willow Creek, but this mod definitely looks the best in Willow Creek, because Danny Paradise says that they made this mod with Willow Creek in mind, and you can see that because it does look the best. And I've never noticed this bridge before over here. Oh well, I've lost it, that bridge there. So yeah, this is Willow Creek, and now we'll go on to Oasis Springs. And here we are now in Oasis Springs in the park. And as you can see, in Oasis Springs, not a lot changes because Oasis Springs is set in the desert. And obviously, autumn doesn't really happen in the desert, and they don't have many trees anyway. So obviously the things such as the cacti and these little shrubs haven't changed, because it'd be weird if that had changed. And the terrain hasn't changed at all, because obviously it's sand, not grass, so that's not going to change. Trees like this have changed, the ones which can be found in other worlds as well. But one thing I have found, I don't know if this is just my game or everyone's games, but as you can see, this tree over here is still green. And then if I go over there, it will change to this autumnal colour. I'm not sure if that's, you know, standard or what. Like, as you can see, these are green now. But I don't really play in Oasis Springs, so that doesn't make a difference for me. But as you can see, this is just what Oasis Springs looks like. Well, the park area. Not a lot has changed. So now we'll go into Newcrest. So here we are in Newcrest in a little park, which I just quickly placed down because I forgot that this world's empty on this save file. And this is just what the trees look like. Obviously, Newcrest is quite a lot like Willow Creek, so the majority of it does work and it still fits in. Because, you know, yeah, like I said, they're practically the same kind of world, just look a bit different. But obviously the grass has changed and all of the trees have changed and the bushes, apart from things such as like these arches, haven't changed. But the thing that I've noticed with this mod is the level of detail that's gone into it. I can't really show you on this world. I'm going to show you when I go back into Willow Creek the level of detail that's gone on for this, and I'll explain that when we can see it. But yeah, this is just what Newcrest looks like. Yeah, it looks pretty good. It looks good, basically. So we're going to go back to Willow Creek now. What I wanted to show you was you've got your normal world here, but the backdrop bits, which just look like this, obviously they're not real trees, even them have been changed, apart from those ones right at the back. But look, these aren't even real trees, they're just that decoration which you can't do anything with. And as you can see, even they have been edited to make the backdrops. If obviously if I go back now, that looks kind of real. That backdrop looks good. So it's just the level of detail that's gone into this. And Danny Paradise must have put so much time and effort into obviously making this mod. And it looks absolutely amazing. And it's something I realised I could do just before I film this was go right off the map. Like, goodbye Willow Creek. Yeah, it's just an amazing mod, and EA, this is going to be something like EA gives us when we do get a season's expansion pack, and Danny Paradise has done a brilliant job of imitating that to start off with. So overall, I rate this mod as a 10 out of 10 if I'm going to rate it. Like, this would be brilliant for storytellers, because obviously they can put in that, like, they can imitate then the years changing and seasons. So it'd be good for storytellers. For me, I think it looks nice, but it doesn't really add a lot to the game because I do storytell, like I do Let's Plays, but not storytell as in where I write blog posts about it and stuff. So seasons isn't that important for me yet. So I think it'd be best for storytellers and people that take pictures and have Tumblr blogs or Simblr blogs. I think that's who it'd work for best. So that's just my opinion on it. I absolutely love this mod, like, as I've said, but I don't think I'm going to keep it in my game, just because I don't need it. And I do kind of like how bright the game is before, like, you have all of this. This does look brilliant, don't get me wrong, but I do like the bright, sunny Willow Creek, and I have no need for this right now. If I ever need it, obviously I can install it again. But apart from that, I have no need, so I am going to uninstall it. But still, it is a great mod, and I might keep it, like, we don't know, I might put it back. And I'm just circling Willow Creek now. But yeah, that's just my little overview of this mod, guys. If you like this, subscribe, and the link to download this will be down below to Danny Paradise's website with this on, and there's a load more information on there. And yeah, bye guys.